simple tip we often hear is resist the urge to upgrade your lifestyle as your income increases. But does this really happen? Well, as our income rises, our expenses rise too. What is critical is that we understand our own patterns and human behavior. The belief that more is better. Let me share about the Diderot effect to explain what I mean here. Famous French philosopher Denis Diderot, co-founder and writer of one of the most comprehensive encyclopedias of the time, lived in poverty most of his life. But that changed in 1765 when his daughter was about to get married. He could not afford to give a dowry, and then Catherine the Great, the Empress of Russia, offered to buy his library for 1,000 Britain pounds. Shortly, Diderot acquired a new scarlet robe, and immediately he noticed how out of place it seemed when surrounded by the rest of his common possessions. In his words, there was no more coordination, no more unity, no more beauty between his robe and the rest of his items. He felt the urge to buy some new things to match the beauty of his robe. He replaced the old rug with a new one from Damascus. He decorated his home with beautiful sculptures and a better kitchen table. He bought a new mirror to place above the mantel and more. These reactive purchases have become known as the Diderot effect. The Diderot effect states that obtaining a new possession often creates a spiral of consumption which leads you to acquire more new things. And we end up buying things we never needed previously to feel happy or fulfilled. Like him, many of us fall victims to the Diderot effect. We buy a new dress and now we have to get shoes and earrings to match. We buy a new gym membership and then we have to get the right clothes and shoes for the gym. As author James Clear in his book Atomic Habits says, we are rarely looking to downgrade, to simplify, to eliminate, to reduce. Our natural inclination is always to accumulate, to add, to upgrade, and to build upon. Here are a few things he's suggesting in his book. I thought they are extremely powerful, so I'm sharing here with you. Number one. Reduce exposure. Nearly every habit is initiated by a trigger or cue. Unsubscribe from commercial emails, opt out of emailing lists, meet friends at the park rather than the mall. Number two, buy items that fit your current system. You don't have to start from scratch each time you buy something new. Example, when you purchase new clothes, look for items that work well with your current wardrobe. Number three, buy one, give one. Each time you make a new purchase, give something away. The idea is to prevent your number of items from growing. What are you getting from these ideas? What are you taking on? The idea is to help you simplify and live the life you love. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Take charge.